Fine. We start with the lecture. Let the other people join. Might be possible. हो सकता है उनका genuine कुछ reason हो due to electric issue, network issue. There might be some chances. Okay. So I don't want to blame them directly. We start with the lecture. Okay. So in the last lecture we have covered a topic called as PSW. Okay. So the topic was called as program status word. So what is a program status word? Can anybody explain it? What is PSW? PSW is what?
Register.
Register. How many bit register?
8-bit.
So it is a 8-bit register. Okay. So what are the important information that it holds? क्या क्या information उसके अंदर होता है? सबसे पहले, the first register, the first bit it has is called as
carry flag.
So carry flag will tell you whether there is a carry in the result or there is no carry. Okay. So if there is a MSB में, if MSB के अंदर if there is a carry generated, in that case carry flag will be made as 1 or 0.
One.
Else it would be made as 0. The second important information that it gives is called as
auxiliary carry.
So if there is a carry generated out of the upper nibble or the higher nibble or the lower nibble.
Lower nibble.
So if there is a carry generated out of the lower nibble, in that case the auxiliary carry flag will be made as 1, else it would be made as 0. After that we have FO. What is FO?
User defined flag.
These are called as user defined flags. So user can use them for their own requirements. So if user ko yahan pe 1 store karna hai to 1 store kar sakta hai, 0 store karna hai 0 store kar sakta hai. So it is up to the user. Okay, so in order to store anything or in order to delete or make it as 0, what are the commands? Do you guys remember the commands for making as 1? F0 ko agar mereko 1 banana hai, FO ko 1 banana hai, so kaise karoge? The command is
set b.
Set B. Okay, and in order to clear it, in order to clear that bit, the command is CLR.
Clear.
Okay, so these are the two commands. And since ये PSW का कौन से नंबर का bit है? It is PSW.0, PSW.1, PSW.4, PSW.5 के कौन से नंबर का ये? It is PSW 5th. So I will have to write PSW.5 over here. So ये अगर मैंने explicitly लिख दिया, इसका मतलब it is setting the FO flag. अगर मैंने PSW.5 के आगे clear लिख दिया, तो ये क्या करेगा? उस bit को clear करेगा. Okay, so F0 FO is nothing but it is a user defined flag. User defined flag का मतलब क्या है? User खुद अपने requirement के हिसाब से इस flag को use कर सकता है. Okay, so that is the third information that I can do. The fourth one is called as RS1 and fifth one is called as RS0. So these two flags are called as, what are these two flags called as?
Register bank select.
Okay, so it is called as a register bank select. Register bank select ka matlab kya hoga? What do you mean by register bank select? It will perform what operation? Do you guys remember it? What does register bank do?
It selects the registers for operation using the combinations of zeros and ones.
Okay, so it selects the register. No, it does not select the register. It selects the bank where the register are there. Okay, so अगर आप आगे जो आज टॉपिक पढ़ने जाएंगे, आज पता नहीं हो पाएगा कि नहीं, वो टॉपिक तक पहुंच पाएंगे कि नहीं, बट मेरे ख्याल से नेक्स्ट क्लास में माइट बी ऑन व्हेन कल इज देयर एनी हॉलीडे डिक्लेयर्ड फॉर टुमारो? अभी तक कुछ डिक्लेरेशन आया?
नॉट येट.
ओके, बट जनरली जन्माष्टमी की छुट्टी होती है कि नहीं होती है?
होती है
ना, लास्ट ईयर मिली थी ना आपको?
यस सर.
ओके,
यस सर.
सो देयर माइट बी एन अनाउंसमेंट, माइट बी शायद शाम तक या रात तक शायद अनाउंसमेंट आ जाए. सो अगर ऐसा हो गया तो कल मुझे नहीं लगता फिर लेक्चर होगा. सो उसके बाद वाले लेक्चर तक शायद हम लोग ये कोशिश करेंगे जो आज मैं डायग्राम यहाँ पे बनाने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. दिस डायग्राम इज द इंटरनल आर्किटेक्चर और द इंटरनल डायग्राम्स ऑफ रैम. ओके, सो इंटरनल रैम है उसका डायग्राम. ओके, सो इंटरनल रैम जो है उसका साइज क्या है? डज एनीबडी नो व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ द इंटरनल रैम? डू यू गाइस रिमेंबर इट? 128 byte. ओके, यानी इसके पास कितने लोकेशन होंगे? हाउ मेनी लोकेशन डज इट विल हैव? कितने लोकेशन होगा 128 बाइट में?
128
इट विल हैव 128 यूनिक लोकेशन इसके पास, यानी 128 लोकेशन होगा. सो द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस ऑफ द लोकेशन वुड बी, स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस वुड बी
0 0 0
एंड द लास्ट एड्रेस वुड बी
1 1
इट वुड बी
7F 7F.
सो द स्टार्टिंग लोकेशन इज 00H and the last location would be 7FH. ye to clear hai na aap sabko? Do you guys remember it, how we have got this value?
Yes sir.
Okay, ab kya karna hai, jo ram hai us ram ke andar there are 32 byte of registers ya 32 byte of location ya 32 byte of space is been stored or is been basically kept only for the general purpose register. yani kya hai 32 aise unique location. this is वन लोकेशन, दिस सेकंड लोकेशन, थर्ड लोकेशन, फोर्थ लोकेशन, ऐसे कितने लोकेशन है हमारे पास? हमारे पास टोटल 32 लोकेशंस है जो हमने रखे हैं फॉर 32 डिफरेंट जनरल पर्पस रजिस्टर. सो हाउ मेनी लोकेशन वी हैव, हाउ मेनी डिफरेंट लोकेशन दैट वी आर दैट आर रिजर्व फॉर रजिस्टर्स, जनरल पर्पस रजिस्टर, हाउ मेनी रजिस्टर्स वी हैव इन 8051? वी हैव 32 सच रजिस्टर्स. कितने रजिस्टर है?
32.
So out of these 32 registers, jitne bhi registers hai, we have to give name to this register. Jaise 8086 mein the name of the registers were AX, BX, CX and DX. Okay? So char the to A, B, C, D unka naam ho gaya. Yahan pe 32 hai, to hum alphabet name to nahi de sakte, hum A, B, C, D to nahi de sakte, kyunki wo 26 ke baad khatam ho jayenge, right? So we cannot give them the alphabetic name. So what we can do is, we can give them R0, R1, we can give this kind of names. Okay, so यहाँ पे नाम जो दिया जाएगा वो R0, R1, फिर R2, ऐसे कहाँ तक नाम होंगे? Ideally होना चाहिए था R31 तक होना चाहिए था, because start from zero तो R31 तक होना चाहिए था. लेकिन R31 तक यानी 32 different names अगर register के use करोगे तो 32 add operation करना पड़ेगा. यानी for example अगर मैं add R0, if I perform add R0 with R1, I can perform the same add operation with R2 as well. So add R0 with R2. Barabar. Similarly, I can perform add R0 with R3. With R3. So sabka opcode same hoga ya opcode alag hoga? The opcode for this one and this one, will it be same or it will be different?
Different.
It will be different because I'm using different set of register. I'm using R1 in first case, R2 in second case, and R3 in third case. So since we are performing operation on different registers, so opcode will naturally will be different. Okay. So since if we have 32 such registers, so add ke andar aise instruction aap 32 kar sakte minimum. Okay, minimum. Aap permutation combination se we can perform R1 R3 ke saath, R2 R4 ke saath. So minimum kam se kam आपको ऐड के लिए 32 इंस्ट्रक्शन लिखने पड़ेंगे. सिमिलरली सबट्रैक्ट के लिए ऐसे 32 इंस्ट्रक्शन लिखने पड़ेंगे. सिमिलरली मल्टीप्लाई के लिए 32 इंस्ट्रक्शन लिखने पड़ेंगे. डिवाइड के लिए मतलब एंड और एक्सॉर यानी हर एक इंस्ट्रक्शन के लिए यू वुड हैव डिफरेंट 32 इंस्ट्रक्शंस बिकॉज़ ऑफ 32 रजिस्टर्स दैट यू होल्ड. ओके, सो विल द प्रोसेस ऑफ डीकोडिंग, विल इट बी फास्टर और इट विल बिकम स्लोअर?
स्लोअर.
स्लोअर क्योंकि लुकअप टेबल के अंदर जो एंट्रीज होंगी ऑपकोड की वो बहुत ज्यादा होगी, तो उसके अंदर से आपको जो स्कैनिंग का प्रोसेस होगा वो डिले हो जाएगा. स्कैनिंग से जो आप डिकोडिंग जो कर पाते हो वो प्रोसेस स्लो हो जाएगा. तो विल यू बी एबल टू अचीव द ट्रू पाइपलाइनिंग? यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू अचीव द ट्रू पाइपलाइनिंग क्योंकि आपका डिले होने की वजह से, आपका जो डिकोडिंग है उसमें डिले होने की वजह से आप आगे का इंस्ट्रक्शन को फेच और एग्जीक्यूट नहीं कर पाओगे. बराबर ना? सो दैट इज व्हाई दिस प्रॉब्लम मे कॉज अ प्रॉब्लम. Okay, so 32 naam, different naam dene se acha hum kya karenge? What we'll do, instead of naming them as R0 to R32, R31, we'll name them from R0 to R7. Kahan tak jayenge? R0 se R7. Okay, so R0 se R7 mein kitne register ho jate hain? How many registers from R0 to R7 will have?
8
registers. Okay, so hamare paas 8 aise register honge. Okay, so ye 8 ke group mein hum 8 रजिस्टर के ग्रुप को, एक ग्रुप को हम एक बैंक बोलते हैं. ओके, सो वी कॉल देम अ बैंक. इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ हाउ मेनी रजिस्टर्स? अ ग्रुप ऑफ 8 रजिस्टर्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम R0 टू R7. सो टोटल में कितने रजिस्टर्स हैं? हाउ मेनी जनरल पर्पस रजिस्टर वी हैव? 32. ईच बैंक हैज 8 रजिस्टर्स इन इट. सो हाउ मेनी बैंक आर पॉसिबल?
4.
सो वी हैव गॉट 4 बैंक्स. सो वो 4 बैंक्स के नाम क्या होंगे? व्हाट विल बी द डिफरेंट नेम्स ऑफ दिस बैंक? बैंक 0, बैंक 1, कहां तक जाएगा ये?
बैंक 3.
बैंक 3 तक जाएगा. क्लियर है ये? समझ में आ गया? दिस इज द इंटरनल आर्किटेक्चर बेसिकली. सो अगर मैं इसका डायग्राम बनाने की कोशिश करूं, अगर इफ आई ट्राई टू रीडिजाइन द डायग्राम, सो द इंटरनल रैम हैज 3 बैंक्स. ओके, सो बैंक 0, दिस इज बैंक 1, दिस इज बैंक 2, एंड दिस इज बैंक 3. ओके, सो इट हैज गॉट 3 बैंक. दिस इज बैंक 0, दिस इज बैंक 1, दिस इज बैंक 2, दिस इज बैंक 3. हैव आई स्टार्टेड द रिकॉर्डिंग पार्ट?
यस.
Okay.
Yes,
okay. So I've got 3. This last one is bank 3. Sorry for that. This is bank 3. Okay. So total I've got 4 different banks. Okay. Har bank mein kitne register hai?
8.
Aur unka naam kya hai? What are the names for it? R0
to R7.
R7. To sab mein wahi naam hai. Sab bank mein wahi naam hai. Okay. So isse benefit kya mil jata hai? Ki add ke jo pehle 32 instruction hote the, वो क्या हो जाएंगे? कितने हो जाएंगे? कितने एट. सो एड R0 टू R1, एड R0 R2, एड R0 R3, R0 R4, R0 5, R0 R5, R0 R6, R0 R7, R0 R8. देयर इज नो सच रजिस्टर कॉल्ड एज R8. सो हाउ मेनी इंस्ट्रक्शन आर देयर इन एड? 8. सिमिलरली फॉर मल्टीप्लाई वी कैन हैव 8 different instructions. For divide we can have 8, for add we can have 8. So we have reduced from 32 number, we have reduced to 8 such instructions. Okay, so decoding by dividing the memory into banks, the decoding will become faster or it will become slower?
Faster.
Okay, so that is what I want to just say. So this topic mein ye pura discussion isme nahi hai, aage wale topic mein discussion hai. Okay, so just I want to say is ki ye jo registers hai, these registers are divided into different banks. Okay, so ye jo registers aap bank mein dalte ho, aur har bank mein how many registers we have? We have 8 such registers. Is it clear? And the naming of these registers will be from, in each bank will be from R0 to R7. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's say if I want to perform the operation which is add R0 to R1. Ye operation mujhe karna hai. Okay. I want to perform the operation of add R0 to R1. What is actually happening over here? R0 ka content aur R1 ka content add ho jayega. Aur result kahan pe store hoga? R0 mein, R1 mein?
R0
mein. But ye R0 kiska hoga? Bank 0 ka, bank 1 ka, bank 2 ka, bank 3 ka. Ya R1 kiska hoga? Bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 ya bank 3? किसका होगा? कौन से बैंक की बात चल रही है यहाँ पे? Have we decided that yet?
No,
we have not yet decided. Okay, so at a time only one bank can be activated. Okay, so I cannot activate two bank at a time. So ऐसा नहीं होगा कि R0 of bank 0 and R1 of bank 2 या R0 of bank 1 and R1 of bank 3. It is not possible. Okay, so जो भी रजिस्टर पे हम वर्क करेंगे दैट इज सोली रिलेटेड टू ओनली वन बैंक एट अ टाइम. एक ही बैंक पे ही काम कर सकते हो आप एक टाइम पे. ओके, सो द ऑपरेशन बिटवीन द बैंक्स इज नॉट पॉसिबल, दैट इज नॉट सपोर्टेड एट ऑल. ओके, सो एट अ टाइम ओनली वन बैंक विल बी एक्टिवेटेड. सो इन ऑर्डर टू एक्टिवेट द बैंक, विच टू बिट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट? विच टू बिट्स इंफॉर्मेशन विल टेल मी कि मैं किस बैंक पे वर्क कर रहा हूँ? सो दैट टू बिट्स आर RS1 एंड RS0. So RS1 and RS0, which is present in the PSW register, उस PSW register में RS1 और RS0 मुझे बताएगा कि मेरा कौन सा bank active है. ये कैसे बताएगा? RS1 और RS0 का एक truth table आप बनाओगे. इस truth table में we generally write 00, 11, and over here we write 0101. Okay? So if the content of RS1 and RS0 both are 0, in that case the bank which will be activated is, which bank will be activated?
Bank 0.
If the content of RS1 is 0 and RS0 is 1, in that case which bank will be activated?
Bank 1.
If the content content of RS1 is 1 and the content of RS0 is 0, in that case bank 2 will be activated, and if both are 1, in that case bank 3 will be activated. Is it clear? Is this operation clear to you?
Mm-hmm.
ओके, सो सवाल जो आपको पूछा जाएगा एग्जाम में, they will ask you explicitly, aapko sawal pucha jayega, perform this operation while activating on bank 1 or on activating bank 2, bank 3, aisa aapko exam mein sawal pucha jayega. So please remember to read the question correctly, okay? So agar by chance agar wahan pe bank 3 likha hai aur aapne jaldi mein bank 2 ko activate kar diya, bank 0 ko activate kar diya, तो आपका वहां पे मार्क्स कट हो सकता है. सो अगर मान लो मुझे बैंक 2 को एक्टिवेट करना है, ओके, आई वांट टू एक्टिवेट बैंक 2, सो व्हाट आई विल डू, व्हाट इज द कमांड फॉर दैट, आई वांट टू एक्टिवेट बैंक 2, तो सेट और क्लियर किसको करना पड़ेगा, आई वांट टू परफॉर्म सेट बी ऑपरेशन और क्लियर, सो सेट बी किसको करोगे, क्लियर किसको करोगे, आरएस 1 को सेट
करेंगे.
RS1 कौन सा PS वो है, PSW पॉइंट 4 है, 5 है, 6 है, 7 है, कौन सा है, PSW पॉइंट
4
एंड क्लियर किसको करोगे, RS0 को क्लियर करोगे, तो इट इज PSW पॉइंट
3.
सो दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम दैट विल बी डिस्कसिंग अगेन इन द लेटर पार्ट. सो जनरली ये दो पार्ट, ये प्रोग्राम जब आप लिखोगे, ये इंस्ट्रक्शन लिखोगे, ये क्या करेगा, आपके RS1 को 1 बना देगा और RS0 को 0 बना देगा. सो इससे क्या हो जाएगा, कौन सा बैंक एक्टिवेट हो जाएगा आपका, विच बैंक गेट्स एक्टिवेटेड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस टू इंस्ट्रक्शन,
बैंक
2. सो वॉट एवर ऑपरेशन नाउ यू विल बी परफॉर्मिंग दैट विल हैपन ऑन टू द रजिस्टर व्हिच इज देयर इन बैंक 2. सो R0 R7 उस केस में बैंक 2 का ही आप यूटिलाइज करोगे, ना कि बैंक 3 का, ना कि बैंक 1 का, ना कि बैंक 0 का. इज इट क्लियर? सो द वर्किंग ऑफ RS1 एंड RS0, इज इट क्लियर टू यू? इज इट क्लियर? सो RS1 एंड RS0 आर कॉल्ड एज द रजिस्टर बैंक सिलेक्ट बिट. सो ये क्या करता है, आपका जो रजिस्टर बैंक है उसको सिलेक्ट करता है. सो वी हैव गॉट 4 सच रजिस्टर्स. सो 4 रजिस्टर के लिए वी नेचुरली रिक्वायर 2 बिट्स ओनली. सो अगर कोई भी 4 में से कोई भी आपको एक सेलेक्ट करना है तो 2 ही बिट का आपको डेटा लगेगा. सो RS1 और RS0 डिसाइड करेगा कि आपका कौन सा बैंक एक्टिवेटेड है, इज इट बैंक 0, इज इट बैंक 1, इज इट बैंक 2 और बैंक 3, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ट्रुथ टेबल दैट हैज बीन डिजाइंड ओवर हियर. ओके, इज इट क्लियर? इज दिस पार्ट क्लियर? ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट इंफॉर्मेशन आफ्टर RS1 एंड RS0, व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट इंफॉर्मेशन दैट वी गेट, इट इज कॉल्ड एज साइन फ्लैग जो है, यानी जो आपका MSB है, इफ इट इज शोइंग 1 इट मींस द नंबर इज नेगेटिव, इट इज शोइंग 0 दैट मींस द नंबर इज पॉजिटिव. अगर ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग 1 होगा it means whatever sign is of my number is it is wrong, it should be vice versa of it. Okay, so overflow flag kya batata hai ki sign is not the correct sign, it is vice versa of it. Agar overflow flag mera 0 hoga, so whatever is sign that is the correct sign. So overflow flag just helps me to rectify the sign of assigned numbers. Okay, so overflow is only valid in case of signed numbers or unsigned numbers,
signed numbers.
Only in case of signed numbers. And during that case, जो भी साइन होगा वो डिपेंड करेगा मेरे ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग पे. अगर ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग मेरा 1 होगा तो साइन जो भी होगा वो सही होगा या उल्टा होगा? अगर ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग मेरा 0 होगा तो साइन मेरा करेक्ट होगा या रॉन्ग होगा? So that is the working of the overflow flag. So overflow flag का मतलब ये नहीं कि मेरा result overflow हो रहा है कि नहीं. Yeah, it is. It generally means that it is overflowing. But what it tells is something else. It tells me whether my sign is correct or it is wrong. Okay. Next we have a flag which is called as a don't care. So don't care का मतलब it can have any value. It does not. It is not related to us. Okay. So it does not have. We don't care basically regarding that particular thing. And the last we have is called as
parity.
So parity tells me what?
Number of ones
is odd or even, that has been decided by parity flag. So if the number of ones is even, in that case it would be what? Parity flag will be
zero.
Made as what?
Zero.
If it is odd, in that case it would be made as
one.
So that is what all related to PSW flag register. So is this register clear to you?
Yes.
Okay, so we'll go to the next part. Write down the next topic as memory organization of 8051. Write down the next topic as memory organization of 8051. Okay, written with the heading. Okay, so memory organization of 8051. Yani basically हमें पढ़ना है memory के बारे में 8051. So how many memories does 8051 has?
Four.
Which are these memories?
Internal, external, RAM.
Okay, so we have got RAM and ROM, and these RAM and ROM can be internal as well as external. Okay. So first of all, we'll be discussing about ROM. Okay. So write down the first heading as ROM. Okay. We'll be discussing about ROM. So the full form of ROM is read only memory. It can also be called as which memory?
Program memory.
Program memory. So write down the alternate name. It can also be called as program memory, or it can also be called as code memory. So इसको दो नाम दिया जाता है. Apart from raw, you can also call it as a program memory, or you can also call it as a code memory. Okay. So write down about ROM. What is ROM? ROM. I think you also know about it. So the full form of ROM is read only memory. It can be called as program memory or code memory because it stores only program. Because it stores only program. Okay. Then write down. Is it volatile or non-volatile?
Non-volatile.
It is non-volatile in nature. So write down that point as well. It is non-volatile in nature. Okay. Next, in 8051, ROM are of two different type. One is called as internal ROM, and second one is called as external ROM. So in 8051, we have got two different types of ROM. One is called as internal, and second one is called as external ROM. Okay, done with that part? Done with the writing part?
Yes.
Okay, now we'll go to the explanation part. I will explain you, and just please pay attention all of you. Okay. So 8051 में जो आप ROM connect करते हो, whatever ROM that you connect, उसको connect करने का there are three scenarios. Okay, I've got scenario number one. Scenario one, I've got scenario number two, I've got scenario number three. यानी मेरे को अगर ROM connect करना है, मैं तीन तरीके से इसको connect कर सकता हूँ. First scenario is, I'll be connecting only the internal ROM. Okay, so I'll be connecting which memory? Only the internal ROM. Clear with that part?
Yes.
Third scenario क्या बोलता है कि I'll be connecting only the external ROM. I'll be discarding the internal ROM completely और मैं सिर्फ external ROM को ही use करूँगा. Okay. The third scenario says that I'll be using only the external ROM. And second scenario says that what will be the second scenario? Any guess? It would connect both internal ROM plus external ROM. So it is a combination of internal ROM plus the external ROM. So these are the three scenarios that I can use my internal ROM for connecting. Okay. So this is the internal and this is the external. Okay. So please draw the diagram. Okay. All of you. And write down the explanation in between. जहाँ पे कुछ भी point आता है वो आप लिख के चले जाओ. I'll be sharing this slide. I'll be sharing the notes of the students that has written down. But still, आप अपने points अपने तरफ से अपने points खुद लिखोगे तो ज़्यादा better होगा. Okay? Is the three scenarios clear to you? तीन scenario क्या है? अगर आपको ROM connect करना है आपको 8051 में, वो तीन तरीके से आप connect कर सकते हो. या तो सिर्फ आप internal ROM connect करो, या तो सिर्फ आप external ROM connect करो. या तो आप कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल ROM को कनेक्ट करने की कोशिश करो. डन विद दैट पार्ट? इज इट क्लियर? ओके, नाउ टेल मी द साइज ऑफ इंटरनल ROM. व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ द इंटरनल ROM? इस इंटरनल ROM की साइज क्या होगी?
4KB.
सो 4KB इज द साइज ऑफ दिस इंटरनल ROM. सो 4KB अगर इसका साइज होगा, व्हाट वुड बी द स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस इन हेक्साडेसिमल? starting address would be? I think we have discussed regarding this.
0, 0, 0.
How many zeros?
4.
4 zeros. Why 4 zeros? 4 KB में कितने bit होते हैं? 4 kilobyte का मतलब कितना unique location? How many unique location it will have? Yeah, so it has 4000 unique location. 4000 unique location यानी it would have 2 to 12 different location. यानी 12 bit के address में आप इसका unique location आप find कर सकते हैं. लेकिन as the computer says that it should be a power of 2. So the nearest power of 2 is 16. So that is why we have to give the address of 16 bit address only. Okay? So यहाँ पे जो आप address दोगे, starting address होगा वो क्या होगा? 0000H. Is it clear? Starting address समझ में आया क्या होगा? कैसे आया? ये समझ में आ गया ना आपको?
Yes.
Okay. Because the size was 4 KB, the last address would be
0FFF.
It would be 12 bit as 1. 12 bit will be made as 1. और बाकी के चार 0 जो हैं आपके 0 ही रहेंगे. So it would be the first will be 0. उसके बाद के सारे 1-1 होंगे. So 1-1-1-1 will be called as F. उसके बाद फिर से F. उसके बाद फिर से F. So the last address would be 0FFFH. Is it clear? Last address भी समझ में आ गया?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is all you want to write down in scenario 1. So what you have to write down in scenario 1 and overall in lump sum? In scenario 1, you can write down, in the first case or in the scenario 1, only the internal ROM is activated, only the internal ROM is connected to the 8051, where the size of the internal ROM is only 4 KB. Thus, the starting address would be 0000H and the last address would be 0FFFFH. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is all you want to write down in scenario 1. अब scenario 2 की बात करते हैं. Sorry, scenario 3 की बात करते हैं. Scenario 2, दोनों combination को हम लोग उसके आराम से बात करेंगे. Scenario 3 पे जाते हैं. So scenario 3 is nothing but it is a external RAM. Just external RAM को ही आपको connect करना है. Okay, आपको internal RAM को completely discard करना है. Okay? So there is a pin in 8051 which does that. Who decides that? Which pin decides whether you are discarding or you are using internal RAM?
EA.
EA bar. Only, not only EA, it is EA bar. Okay? So EA bar ka content kya hoga in case of scenario 1? What would be the content of EA bar in case of scenario 1?
0.
1.
1 kiya to ye external, ye kya hoga? 1 ka matlab it is active low, so ye 0 ban jayega, iska matlab it will be using the internal ROM. Over here, the content of EA bar will be made as? Made as?
0.
0. यहाँ पे EA bar को अगर मैंने 0 बनाया तो क्या करेगा? Internal access जो है आपका, यानी EA का मतलब क्या होता है? External access. You want to access the external memory. Okay? तो उसको अगर आप activate करोगे, activate कब होगा? जब वो 0 होगा. इसका मतलब आप सिर्फ और सिर्फ external ROM को ही आप use करोगे. यानी आपका internal ROM जो है discard हो जाएगा. Is it clear? So EA bar का content will be made as 0 over here. तो इसका मतलब ये क्या है? It will use only the external ROM. It will not at all use the internal ROM. Is this scenario, is this part clear to you? EA bar should be made as 0 or 1 in scenario 3?
Yes.
EA bar क्या होगा scenario 3 में? 0 की 1?
0.
Why you want to make it as 0? Because in scenario 3, we are not using the internal ROM at all. We are completely discarding the internal ROM. That is why in scenario 3, EA bar should be made as 0. Is this part clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now, the size of the external ROM. What is the size of the external ROM? Can you tell me the size of the external ROM?
64 KB.
64 KB. The size of the external ROM is 64 KB. Because how come the size was 64 KB? Because 64 KB kahan se hai? Magical number hai ya kahin se derive hua 64 KB?
Address bus.
It derived from the address bus because 8051 has the address bus. What is the size of the address bus? Size of the address bus in 8051 is
16.
So because it is, it has an address bus of size of 16. So 16 ko aap kaise likh sakte ho? Yani total memory location kitna hoga? 2:16. So 2:16 can be written down as 2:10 and 2:6. So 2:10 is called as 1K and 2:6 is called as 64. So that is why the size of the memory will be 64 KB. Is it clear? Is this part clear? So since external ROM is of size 64 KB, the starting address will be, all the 16 bits should be made as 0. So the starting address would be 0000H. And what would be the last address? All the 16 bit should be made as 1. So 16 bit 1 karoge to wo last address ban jayega. To wo kya hoga hexadecimal mein?
F.
So we'll be having F, F, F. How many F? How many F? 4F.
Is this part clear?
So what you write, what you need to write down in scenario 2, scenario 3. Scenario 3 mein aap kya likhoge? Only the external ROM is activated. Okay. We will not be using the internal ROM. To make sure, to discard the internal ROM, the content of EA bar should be made as 0. Okay. On making the content of EA bar as 0, only the external ROM gets activated. The size of the external ROM is 64 KB. Since the size of the external ROM is 64 KB, the starting address of the external ROM would be 0000H and the last address would be FFFFH. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll be giving you 1 or 2 minutes, so please write down fast as soon as possible. Then we'll go to the next part, scenario 3, scenario 2. Agar kisi ko doubt hai in between, they can ask me. Does anybody has any doubt? Okay, should we move forward?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so the next part is thoda sa tricky part hai, zyada nahi hai, zyada kuch itna bada nahi hai. I can expect ki aap iska answer barabar doge. Okay, but theek hai, maybe we try karte hain. So internal ROM, so scenario 2 says that ki not only I'll be using internal ROM, agar internal ROM bhar jata to I can still have the capacity to connect the external ROM. So scenario 2 kya bolta hai ki the ROM will work in the combination of internal plus external ROM. Okay, so iska size kya hoga, what will be the size of it? So internal ROM to fix, what is the size of the internal ROM? Can you tell me size of the internal ROM? Would be
KB.
This size would be equal to 4 KB. What would be the size of the external ROM?
16.
Will it be 60 KB or 64 KB? And why 60 KB and why not 64 KB?
60 KB.
Size will be 60 KB? Why 60 KB, why not 64?
Sir, because overall is maximum 64.
Yeah, because the address bus is of 16 bit, because 8051 supports 16 bit address bus. So jo overall aap memory ko identify kar paoge, us overall jo aap bhi aap identify kar pate ho, us memory ko identify karne ke liye aapko 64 KB unique location hi supported hai. To 64 KB mein se 4 KB jo hai wo aap internal ROM ko de dete ho aur bacha hua jo 60 KB hai wo aap external ROM ko dete ho. Is this part clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. So मैं थोड़ा सा एक काम करता हूँ, ठीक है चलो. So internal ROM का, because we are dealing with internal ROM, okay? Internal ROM का okay. Internal ROM का one second, I just got a call. So internal size का, internal ROM का size is 4 KB. Can you tell me the starting location of internal ROM? What would be the starting location of internal ROM if the size is 4 KB?
0000H.
What would be the last location of internal ROM?
FFFFH.
बराबर ना, ये इसका ending location होगा internal ROM का. What would be the starting location of external ROM? External ROM का starting location क्या होगा?
1000H.
Yeah, exactly. So this is the tricky part. So अगर जिसको समझ में नहीं आ रहा है वो 1000H कैसे आया? It will start from the next address where the internal ROM has ended. So FFFF के बाद 0FFF के बाद जो next address आएगा वो क्या आएगा? 100. ये कैसे आया? 01 के बाद 02 आता है, 03 के बाद 04 आता है, 05 के बाद 06 आता है, 06 के बाद 07, 08, 09, 09 के बाद 0A, 0A के बाद 0B, 0C, 0D, 0E. 0F, 0F के बाद क्या आता है?
10.
10. 10 के बाद 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 19 के बाद 1A. 1A के बाद 1B, 1C, 1D, 1E, 1F. 1F के बाद
20.
20. So similarly यहाँ पे क्या आएगा? 0FFF के बाद 100 के बाद क्या आएगा 100 1 100 2 100 3 और ये कहां तक जाएगा व्हाट विल बी द लास्ट एड्रेस वुड बी
एफ 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 एफ
एफ एफ एफ एफ एच सो दैट वुड बी लास्ट एड्रेस ओके सो प्लीज मैंने डायग्राम उल्टा बना दिया है अगर आप थोड़ा चेंज कर सको तो ज्यादा बेटर होगा ओके सो आई जस्ट इरेज इट ओके क्योंकि मैंने हमेशा स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस जो है वो नीचे से चालू किया था तो इसके लिए रैम जो होगा इंटरनल रैम होगा वो नीचे होगा और एक्सटर्नल रैम जो होगा वो ऊपर होगा सो प्लीज ट्राई टू डू दैट चेंज इफ इट इज पॉसिबल ओके नहीं है तो चलेगा आप कंफ्यूज ना हो जाओ इसलिए मैं चेंज कर रहा हूँ सो आप जनरली इंटरनल रैम जो है वो नीचे रखते हो क्यों क्योंकि आपने स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस नीचे से चालू किया सो स्टार्टिंग एड्रेस वुड बी 0000H ऑफ इंटरनल रैम दिस इज इंटरनल रैम एंड द ending address of internal RAM would be the last address of the internal RAM would be 0FFF3FH and then you have the external RAM who has the size of what is the size of the external RAM external RAM is 60 KB so 60 KB ka jo starting address hoga that would be 1000H the last address would be FFFFH is it clear Is this part clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now tell me. We have got one more thing that is remaining. The content of EA bar. What should be the content of EA bar should be made over here?
One.
It will be one or it will be zero?
Zero.
One.
One. Yeah. So some are saying zero, some are saying one. So naturally, you have internal RAM ko discard. Internal RAM ko discard karo ya use karo. Are you using because that is your first priority. You have to use internal ROM. So EA bar will not tell you ki aap external ko access kar rahe ho ki nahi access kar rahe. What it tells you ki you are discarding the internal ROM or you are using the internal ROM. Okay? Naam bhale uska external access hai. Naam bhale hi wo usko batata hai ki aap external memory ko access kar rahe ho ki nahi kar rahe ho. Lekin what it actually says is that whether internal ROM is discarded or it is being used. Okay? So this case mein because jo aapka internal ROM hai that is used that is given the first priority so that is why EA bar ka content kya ho jayega it would be made as one is it clear is this part clear
yeah
so what you need to write what is what you need to write down in scenario 2 so in scenario 2 you need to write is you basically in scenario 2 we are combining both the internal RAM as well as the internal ROM together okay in order to get the maximum size of the memory as 64 KB because of which the starting address or the size of the internal RAM is 4 KB thus the external memory that it supports has a size of only 60 KB okay therefore the starting address of the internal RAM would be internal ROM would be 0000H and the last address of the internal ROM would be 0FFFFH okay whereas the starting address of the external ROM would be just after where the internal ROM gets ended so that address would be 1000H and the last address of the external ROM would be FFFFH is the part clear and finally EA bar ka content should be made as 1 which suggests that the internal ROM is in use is this part clear
yes
Okay, so take your time. Just write down whatever point I have said. Do you want me to repeat it again in all the scenarios, or you can write down in your own? Do you want me to repeat it? You can do right.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Fine. So take a time of 1 or 2 minutes. Just finish it up, wind it up. But friend, मैं थोड़ा सवाल पूछूंगा इस सिनेरियो के ऊपर. तो आप मुझे बताना वो किस सिनेरियो में फॉल करता है. Whenever you are done, you just tell me so that I can start with the next question.
हाँ हेलो लिंडा मैम, कॉल किया था आपने? ओके 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 मेरा क्या हो गया ना मैम, दिस इज लाइक माय कंटिन्यूअस 2 लेक्चर्स हो चुके हैं मेरा. अभी MEP चालू है मेरा. अच्छा 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 मेरा भी लेक्चर चालू है फिलहाल. हाँ, ठीक. हेलो, आर यू डन विद दैट पार्ट? Have you written down in your own words? Should we go to the next part? Should we proceed? Okay. So now I'll just give you a scenario. Let's say I want to perform an operation which is like move A comma. Okay. At the rate, I'm giving an address of let's say 0123. ओके, सो ओवर हियर अगर आप यहाँ पे थोड़ा फॉर्मेट अलग हो जाता है 8051 में और 8086 में. 8086 में अगर हमको एड्रेस देना पड़ता तो हम स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट में देते थे. ओके, वेयर एज ओवर हियर व्हेनेवर वी गिव एड्रेस इन दिस केस वी हैव टू यूज द सिंबल कॉइलेस एट द रेट. ओके, सो जस्ट उस अभी फिलहाल के लिए उतना ध्यान में रखो. ओके, सो व्हाट वी यूज फॉर गिविंग द एड्रेस इज कॉइलेस एट द रेट. क्लियर विद दैट पार्ट? समझ में आया? इज इट क्लियर? So what we are doing over here is, so हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे कि 0123H location पे जो भी आपका प्रोग्राम है या जो भी आपका इंस्ट्रक्शन है उस इंस्ट्रक्शन को हम कौन से रजिस्टर में मूव कर रहे हैं? कौन से रजिस्टर में मूव कर रहे हैं? A, which is accumulator, बराबर ना? बराबर?
Yes.
And what would be the size of the instruction? What would be the size of the instruction which is coming, which is stored at 0123H? साइज क्या होगा?
8 बिट.
और एक्यूमुलेटर का साइज भी 8 बिट है तो दिस इज अ वैलिड इंस्ट्रक्शन, बराबर ना? सो अभी मुझे सिर्फ इतना बताओ ये 0123H कहां पे होगा? विल इट फॉल इन सिनेरियो 1, सिनेरियो 2, सिनेरियो 3?
सिनेरियो 1.
सो यू विल बी गेटिंग दिस प्रोग्राम आउट ऑफ इंटरनल रॉम, एक्सटर्नल रॉम? इंटरनल रॉम. So this is wrong basically because ये decide कौन करेगा whether you're working on internal ROM or external ROM? It will, you have to check the content of EA bar first. इसको check करोगे EA bar को. So let's say मैंने EA bar को check किया, EA bar का content जो है that is zero. Now tell me in which scenario it will fall?
External ROM.
It is external ROM. इसका मतलब EA bar zero है, इसका मतलब I am not using internal ROM at all. What I'm using is only the external ROM. External ROM के अंदर there is a address, let's say 0123H, ये वाला address है, okay? This address पे whatever the program that is being stored, that program has to be moved into A register. Is it clear? Is this part clear to you?
Yes.
Now let's say EA bar का जो content है that is made as 1. Now in which scenario it will fall? In which scenario it will fall? It will fall in 1 or will it fall in 2 or it will fall one. In both? It will fall in both case. 0123H kahan pe? Scenario 1 mein bhi milega address aur 01 scenario 2 mein bhi milega. So there is a address called as 0123H which is there in scenario 1 as well aur scenario 2 mein bhi aapko address milega. Okay, so aapko dono scenario mein mil sakta hai lekin achhi baat ye hai ki you are working in which memory? Internal or external?
Internal.
So there is no confusion over there. You're working in internal memory, so there is no problem with that. Okay. Let's say I've got an address which is called as, instead of 00, I'll be using an address called as 1123H. Okay. So I've updated my address. So 1123H pe address pe jo mera program hai, wo program ko mujhe accumulator mein dalna hai. Aur EA ka jo content hai that is 1. So which scenario you are working on?
Second.
you will be working only on scenario 2. So that means you're working on which ROM, RAM or external or
external?
External. 1.1.1.2.3x, your location, it is present in external ROM. So, and it is because EA bar is made as one. So in that case, apart from, you're not only discarding your internal ROM, you're using internal ROM as well. But that memory that you're talking about, that memory is there in external ROM. Is that part clear? Is that part clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now for the same scenario, let's say EA bar ka content is made as zero. If the content of EA bar is made as zero. So which scenario it will be working?
A.
Scenario? 1, 2, or 3?
Third.
So there is a location called as 0, 1, 2, 3 in three, scenario 3, which is in the external ROM only. Jahan pe, kya hoga? 0, 1, 1, 2, 3 location pe jo aapka program hoga, wo aapko accumulator mein store karna padega. Is this part clear to you?
Yes.
Okay, so, by looking at the address, so what is the conclusion out of all this questionnaire? Ye sare questionnaire ka main conclusion kya hai? Conclusion kya hai? Ki by just looking at the address, we cannot say that either you're working on internal ROM or external ROM, or you're working in which scenario. For telling the scenarios, or for telling which memory you're working in, the most important pin is called as which pin?
EA bar.
That is why we have to check the content of EA bar first. If the content of EA bar is 1, it means that you're working on which?
Internal ROM.
You are not discarding the internal ROM, and you're working in which scenario? You're working in either scenario 1 or you're working in either scenario 2. If the address is greater than 0FFFH, in that case, you are definitely working on external ROM. Barabar? अगर सिनेरियो 1 और सिनेरियो 2 में एड्रेस जो है वो 0FFFH से ज्यादा होगा, इसका मतलब गारंटीड आप एक्शन रॉम पे वर्क कर रहे हो.
यस.
इफ द एड्रेस इज बिलो 0FFFH, इसका मतलब ये है, क्या है, यू आर वर्किंग सिनेरियो 1 और यू आर वर्किंग सिनेरियो 2, इट इज नॉट रिलेवेंट बिकॉज़ यू आर डेफिनेटली श्योर दैट यू आर वर्किंग इन इंटरनल रॉम ओनली. इज इट क्लियर?
यस.
सो बेसिकली अगर मैं ये बोलूं, अगर मैं एक्सटर्नल एक्सेस का पिन हटा देता हूं, मान लो मैं एक्सटर्नल एक्सेस के पिन को कंप्लीटली अवॉइड कर देता हूं, और मैंने आपको बोला टेल मी 1123H लोकेशन, ये कहां पे है, तो आप क्या बोलोगे? 1123H कहां पे होगा? एक्सटर्नल रॉम में. बराबर ना? अगर मैंने आपको बोला ईए का पिन नहीं है, अगर मैंने बोला 0123H कहां पे है? 0123H सिनेरियो 0123H. सो एक्सटर्नल रैम के अंदर भी एक एड्रेस है ना 0123H, एक्सटर्नल रॉम में भी होगा. सो यहां पे आपका कंफ्यूजन आ जाएगा, यू विल गेट कंफ्यूज्ड, द प्रोसेसर विल गेट कंफ्यूज्ड व्हेदर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 0123H ऑफ इंटरनल रॉम और यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 0123H ऑफ एक्सटर्नल रॉम. सो इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड, इन ऑर्डर टू कंप्लीटली डिस्कार्ड दैट कंफ्यूजन, वी हैव टू हैव अ पिन कॉल्ड एज ईए बार. अब ईए बार का कंटेंट अगर मैं 0 लगा देता हूं, इसका मतलब आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली द एक्सटर्नल रॉम. Okay, so that address which is 0123H, that address that we are talking about, that address is present in external ROM. Agar main EA bar ka content, agar main 1 kar deta hun, iska matlab I am talking about the only internal ROM kind. Is that part clear to you? Is it clear?
Yes.
So do you want me to repeat it again? I will just take what we have discussed in the ROM part, RAM ka part, because we are running out of time. I think we have got only 6 minutes left, 6 or 7 minutes left. So we cannot start the RAM part right now. We'll just take the quick revision of ROM. So we'll start with the memory organization of 8051. So memory organization of 8051 kya bolta hai? Ki hamara jo 8051 hai, uske andar jo memory jo aap connect kar sakte ho, wo 4 different tarike se aap memory ko connect kar sakte ho. Because it supports 4 different types of memory. So what are the 4 different memories it supports? It has internal RAM, it has internal ROM, it has external RAM, and it has external ROM. Okay, so basically it supports 2 different types of memory. One is called as a ROM and another is called as a RAM. So what is the full form of ROM? Full form of ROM is read only memory. It is also called as which memory?
Program memory.
It is also called as code memory.
Code memory.
Whereas RAM is called as random access memory. It is also called as which memory?
Data memory.
It is also called as data memory. Okay, so these are the two memories which has been supported by 8051. Ab uske andar internal hai ki external hai kya hai wo aap aage dekhenge. So we have started with the ROM first. So jo ROM hai wo ROM ke andar do variety hai, one is called as internal ROM, other is called as external ROM. Internal ROM ka size kya hota hai, what is the size of the internal ROM?
4 KB.
4 KB, which is fixed, which is final, which cannot change. The size of the external ROM is, the maximum size of the external ROM that it can support is 64 KB. Okay, but it can also change. If you're working in scenario 2, it, in that case the size of the external ROM will be
60 KB.
60 KB. Whereas if you're working only in scenario 3, in that case the size of the external ROM will be 64 KB. So the maximum size supported by external ROM will be 64 KB. Okay, now the ROM can be connected, or these two combination of internal and external ROM can be connected in 3 different scenarios. I've got 3 different scenarios by which I'll be working in either of the scenarios. So the scenario 1 says that I'll be only having the internal ROM connected. Scenario says that I'll be using both the combination of internal ROM plus the external ROM. And scenario 3 says that I'll be using the combination or I'll be using only the external ROM itself. Okay, so ye teen mote mote taur pe teen scenarios hi hai hamare paas ROM ko connect karne ke. Okay, so first scenario kya bolta hai ki I'll be using only internal ROM. So agar main sirf internal ROM use karunga, the size of the internal ROM would be
4 KB.
So 4 KB hone ki wajah se jo starting address hoga wo kya hoga, 0000h, aur jo last address hoga wo hoga 0FFFH. So let's say, agar main is case mein, when I'm working in scenario 1, let's say if I perform an operation move A at the rate 1123H. So will this address be valid or it will be invalid? It will be invalid because no such address is there, because we have not connected the external ROM. Okay. So in that case, scenario 1 mein, the address above 0FFFH A will be invalid address. Okay. So whatever the address which is between 000H to 0FFFH, those address will be the only the valid address. Is that part clear? In scenario 2, we'll be having the combination of the internal ROM as well as the external ROM. So since the first priority is always given to the internal ROM, so sabse pehle jo aapka jo 4 KB hoga wo aapka internal ROM lega. Or because 8051 has a address bus of size, what is the size of the address bus?
16 KB.
The maximum memory that it can support is 64 KB. Out of that 64 KB, since 4 KB has been already taken by the internal ROM, what is the size of the external ROM that can be taken in this scenario?
60 KB.
So the size of the external ROM that can be supported in scenario 2 is 60 KB, and the size of the internal ROM which is always fixed, its size is 4 KB. So the total size of memory in case of scenario 2 is 64 KB. So the starting address of the internal ROM will be 0000H, and the last address of the internal ROM would be 0FFH. Okay, so that is what given to the address there in the internal ROM. Apart from them, the next address, which is 1000H, that is the starting location of the external ROM. And the last address of the external ROM would be, what would be the last address?
4FFH.
Okay, so that would be the last address. Okay, so that is scenario 2. Then we have got the last scenario, which is called as a scenario 3. Scenario 3 kya bolta hai ki it will be using only the internal ROM. It will not be, it will be using only the external ROM. It will not be using the internal ROM. So in order to discard that internal ROM, it has to use, or it has to update the content of EA pin to 0. So EA bar ka content jo hai, ya EA pin pe jo content aapka aa raha hai, usko aap 1 ki jagah pe aap 0 kar doge. 0 karne se kya ho jayega, it will discard the internal ROM completely. So it will be using only the external ROM, because 8051 has a address bus of size 16 bit. The maximum memory that it can support is 64 KB. Since we are not using the internal ROM, that is why the external ROM that it can support, the size of the external ROM would be, what would be the size?
64 KB.
Why 64 KB? Because we have discarded the internal ROM. Internal ROM does not exist at all. So iske liye jo size hoga wo pura ka pura aapka EA bar ka puri tarah se utilize hoga. So 64 KB ka aap EA bar 64 KB ka aap external ROM connect karoge, aur uske baad aap koi bhi address aap doge, wo address kahan pe hoga? Within the external ROM itself. Is this part clear?
Yes.
Okay, so that's the part of the ROM part. RAM ka we will start this discussion in the next class. Okay, so RAM ke andar basically filhal
we have got 2 minutes left, so just we'll give you an overview, थोड़ा idea दे रहे थे. So RAM जो है वो दो part में आप नहीं कर सकते, या तो आप सिर्फ internal RAM लगा दो, okay? या उसके साथ आप external RAM भी लगा दो, okay? So internal RAM का जो size होता है, address bus का size कितने bit का होता है internal RAM का? Internal RAM का sorry. 128. So starting address would be 00H. The last address would be. Last address would be.
FF.
7FH, not FF. FF होता तो 256 हो जाता size. The size is 128 byte. So size is the starting address 00H. Last address would be 7FH. Over here we can also connect external RAM as well. So external RAM आप पूरी तरह से कनेक्ट कर सकते हो. उसका size 64 KB होगा because हम यहाँ पे दो बस यूज कर रहे हैं. एक बस जो होगा वो 8 बिट का बस होगा और दूसरा जो बस होगा वो 16 बिट का होगा. तो 16 बिट का एड्रेस बस होने की वजह से इसका स्टार्टिंग लोकेशन क्या होगा? What would be the starting location? 0000H. And the last location would be all FH. Okay? So last location would be FFFFH. Okay? So अगर आप कोई भी एड्रेस देते हो, let's say मैं अगर यहाँ पे ऑपरेशन देता हूँ मूव ए कॉमा एट द रेट लेट से 50H देता हूँ, तो ये किस एड्रेस की बात हो रही है? इंटरनल रैम की, सॉरी इंटरनल रैम की या एक्सटर्नल रैम की? वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हिच एड्रेस? वी आर टॉकिंग, वी आर वर्किंग ऑन व्हिच मेमोरी? इंटरनल रैम और एक्सटर्नल रैम? आर यू एबल टू हियर मी?
यस.
सो व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ द एड्रेस ओवर हियर? 8 बिट और 16 बिट?
8 bit.
So that means we are giving the address of which memory? Internal RAM or external RAM?
Internal.
It can be both.
How it can be both? अगर ये 50 होता, यहाँ पे अगर आप 50 देते, तो आपको 0050 देना पड़ता, बराबर ना? So there is a difference between 0050 and 50. ये 8 bit address है, ये 16 bit address है, okay? So there is a difference. So if you are working on 8 bit address, that means you are working on internal RAM. If you are working with 16 bit address, that means you are working with external RAM. Is it clear? ओके. और उसके अलावा और भी कुछ डिफरेंसेस है जो हम पढ़ेंगे नेक्स्ट क्लास में. सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू. थोड़ा इंट्रोडक्शन दे दिया. और एक स्पेसिफिक सवाल जो आपको पूछा जाएगा एग्जाम में, जो ज्यादातर पूछा जाता है 10 मार्क के लिए सीधा सवाल मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में, वो कि ड्रॉ द इंटरनल आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ इंटरनल रैम. इंटरनल रैम का आपको मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बनाना पड़ेगा. तो इसके अंदर जो बैंक था, जो 4 बैंक थे, बैंक 0, बैंक 1, बैंक 2, बैंक 3, उसके अलावा आपका बिट एड्रेसेबल स्पेस आ जाता है, स्क्रैच पैड स्पेस आ जाता है, इसका पूरा इंटरनल डायग्राम आपको पढ़ना पड़ेगा. ओके, सो दैट विल बी कवरिंग इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. डन विद दैट पार्ट. समझ में आ गया आज का लेक्चर? किसी को कोई डाउट है? डज एनीबॉडी हैज अ डाउट?
नो सर.
ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट ट्राई टू स्विच ऑफ टुडेस लेक्चर. वी टर्मिनेट द टुडेस क्लास. थैंक यू गाइस, थैंक यू सो मच. यू कैन लीव नाउ. If anybody has a doubt, they can stay back.
Thank you, sir.